Zijn we niet, Jerry? Oeps, ben je weer? Come on, ah. Welkom. I can still cannot see who it is, but it's oh man, my arm is shaking. Woo! And now, hey, Janneke, welcome. Yeah, good morning. And I really don't know what's going on with me, you know. I had a crazy dream. I was walking with a lot of people. Also with Indians. Oh. Oh no, that's old one. And we came to a place and it was what we call here. Yeah, good morning to you also. A bus. Nobody takes shelter for the rain. Yeah, I don't know how you call it in English, but we call it a bus hock. You know, for where you can stand for the rain. You're waiting for the bus. That must be moved. And everyone wants to start work, and I said, no, no, not necessary. And they looked at me, and I did a fire yagya. Can you imagine a fire yagya? And that bus got you moved from there to another place. And then I saw a lot of demigods. And he started talking to me, only I did not understand what they were saying. Crazy, eh? So let me first of all offer my humble basis at the lotus feet of my amazing Acharya, Srila Gaura Hari Das Maharaj. Ah, Mary! Woo! My two mothers are here! Yay! Who is the best friend that you ever could have? I offer my humble basis at the lotus feet of Prabhupada, who brought us immense treasures of the pastime of Radha and Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so that we can now follow in the footsteps of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu through the mercy of our amazing Acharya, Srila Gaura Hari Das Maharaj. I offer my humble basis at the lotus feet of the six Goswamis. I offer my humble basis at the lotus feet of the two Gopikas, the dear friend of Radharani, Lalita Visakha. But also very dear to this one. Ah, good morning. I offer my humble, well, it is lighted. I offer my humble basis at the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna. I offer my humble basis to all the family members, all the disciples, and all the listeners. Welcome. Yeah, I'm sleeping now a little bit longer because I have to take some medicine because I have probably the body. What to do? Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Kadar. Oh, this is about water. Sinavata Kaura Bhakta Vrihanda. Let's glorify the Lord. less pleasing his senses. Yeah, I'm gonna chant and I'm gonna read something, one verse that River read yesterday, because of something, again, something amazing insight. Now, this is really what I like in is that somebody is reading and one devoting is, oh, another devoting reads something else, another devoting says, oh. So you see, this actually Krishna is doing this. Why? So that we can talk everybody's angle, you see? Krishna is using us. Yeah, he's using us, really. He's already using us now for talking about his pastime, but on different angles. You see, that is why also, like for Freddy said, how is it possible that they talk different? Yes, it is the Lord from which angle he wants to show something to us. It seems total opposition, but is it not? And also time, place, and circumstances.
Nita ni mai. Ha ha ha!
Oh, Christa. Oh. Nimai, nitai, nimai. Oei. Nitai, nimai, nitai, nimai. Nitai, nimai. Nitai, nimai. Nitai, nimai. Oh. Nitai, nimai. Nimai. Ah. I start sweating. Oh, Krista, Krista, Krista. Oh, Krista, Krista, Krista. Yeah, it's a really good morning already. Oh, Krista, Krista. Wake up and have some fun with the Lord. Krista, Krista. Oh, Krista. Hare Krista, Hare Krista, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krista, Hare Krista, 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 Hare Hare. Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krista Hare Krista 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 Hare Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krista Hare Krista 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 Hare Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krista Hare Krista 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 Hare Hare Pardon Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krista Hare Krista 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 Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Ha ha ha! Oh, Christa. Mothers, your son is total crazy. Heidi kiste, heidi kiste, 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 wat is er hier? Heidi dam, Christa. One moment. Hare Krishna. Oh. My heart is like... Ah, kiste. Ah. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Oh. Krista. Oh man. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama, oh, almost there. Rama Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Yeah, I don't know why, but I started doing this from yesterday, and it gave me so much pleasure, so much different. Even if I start chanting, Nittai Nimai, Nittai Nimai, Nittai Nimai, Nittai Nimai, Nittai Nimai, Nittai Nimai, Nittai Nimai. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Forever increasing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Ah. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama Hare, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama. You have to change a little bit of the light. Because I have one volume. So it's very small written. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo, Namo Bhagavate. Oh yeah, internet problems, sorry. I offer my humble obeisances at my Acharya Srila Gaura Haridasmaraj. I offer my humble obeisances at Vyedavyas. And I offer my humble obeisances at Krishna, that they may guide me. Krishna is ticklish, yeah! Wow. I have still to move the light more. Oh, Krishna, but I hope it's no problem then with this again. Because it's possible to come here darker again. Okay, so there's something that River read yesterday. So that is Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1. Krishna, but yeah, you just missed what? That was an amazing, loving chapa. So this is from Kant. Srimad Bhagavatam Canto 1, Chapter 1, Text 1. O my Lord, say Krishna, Son of Vasudeva. O all providing person of Gautam, I offer my respectful obeisance unto you. I meditate upon the Lord Krishna because he is the absolute truth. and the primeval cause of all causes of creations, substances and destruction of the material universe. He is direct and indirect consciousness of all manifestations, and he is independent. Pardon. And he is independent because there is no other cause beyond him. It is he only who first imparted the Vedic knowledge unto the heart of Brahmaji. Yeah, I'm gonna first read the total. the original living being. By him, even the great sage and demigod are placed in illusion. I hope it you can see me, because then the stable start changing. I have to miss a good light. In illusion, as one is bewildered by the illusion representation of water, fire, air, or land. Sorry, read again. As one is bewildered by the illusion representation of water, sea in fire, or land, sea on water, only because of him do the material universe temporarily manifests by the reaction of the three moods of material nature, appear faculty, although they are unreal. I therefore meditation upon him, Lord Sri Krishna, who is eternal existing and is transcendental Adam, which is forever free from the illusion representation of the material world. I meditate upon him, for he is absolute truth. You see, there was a few things that was for me was amazing in here. Vedic knowledge. Where went it? In the heart of Lord Brahma. Niet hier. And I've ever tried studying this, the books, and put it all here. See, we have the example here also. How was that again? All right. Yeah, Vedic knowledge unto the heart of Brahmaji. A spiritual master open the dark eyes of his disciple, and transcendental knowledge go where? In the heart. See, it is the Lord who is sitting there, that from there we get the knowledge. Because even to mention also, you know, actually, I was thinking also yesterday, you have the truth, you have the absolute truth, yes? So mention it. For he is the absolute truth, but what it actually means? Absolute truth. Because we know Krishna is lying. He's stealing. So what is actually the absolute truth? He is the source of everything. Ah ja, truth. Truth is mentioned the truth. Eh? The absolute truth. You see, that's why it's not easy to understand all this. The absolute truth. So you think there's not, it's true. It's nothing above him. But it depends how you can see it. Because if you say he's the absolute truth, but he's stealing butter in his pastimes for pleasing his devotees. So how can we say then he's the absolute truth? He's the embodiment from everything. He's the beginning, the end, everything. That's the absolute truth. And something amazing inside here. By him, even great sages and demigods are placed into illusion. So, what to say about us? Is even sages and demigods, I put in illusion. So certainly, we people are in illusion also. But association of a pure devotee as our Acharya Srila Gaudiya, we are coming out of this illusion. He is showing us. So you see? So long. Wait, huh? Only because of him do the material universe temporarily manifested by the reaction of the three modes of the natures. So what are the three? Ignorant, passion, goodness. They are temporary, yes? So if you in one of these three, this knowledge is also temporary. We have to come to what? Out of these three modes. Because these three moods are still illusion. Because why? They are still of this material realm. So if you, he was a Christian. I said, good. I said, but good is not enough. I said, like, yes, we have to come above goodness. See, for them, it's not easy to understand this. That we have to come, what? On the transcendental level. Then we are free from material illusion. So see, it's not so easy that people are thinking. Let's mention it. By him, even great sages. And what were these great sages? I forgot the name, you know. But we have this, you see, Lord Brahma created the seven sages. One of his, Krishna, I've got all his names now. Arti is one. Don't worry. See, they were in the illusion. This person in the illusion. Because Arti, he didn't know. Because, I don't know if you know it, but I believe it's Arti that is called the husband of Anasunya. Who get the son, who? Dattatreya. See? He didn't know who was it. So he was meditated. And who came there? Because he had not right fixed idea from who is actually now the source of everything. So, and who came there? Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Shiva. Because in the meditation, was not right. It didn't know it. That's why. How is it possible? Yes. Because in the meditation, he was actually meditation on this tree. Creator, maintainer, destruction. I go say, I'm welcome. So you see, they didn't know it. That's why he came, you see, that's why I was mentioned. By him, even great sages and demigods. So if you want to be a demigod, you're still an illusion. It's not enough. Goodness, not, you see, that is also what Maharaj is trying to explain. Also the Sastra is saying, goodness is still what? Of the material nature. That's why it's mentioned here also. Only because of him do the material universe temporarily manifest by the reaction of the three modes of nature. zitten, still temporary. The three modes. That's why if you are in goodness, it's not enough. Because it's still temporary. You may go to demigods, but also temporary. That's why it's later mentioned. I therefore meditate upon him, Lord Jesus Christ, who is the external existence, eternal existence in the transcendental autumn, which is forever free from the illusion representation of the material world. So we have to come to that point, transcendental. And that's why you need really a person who can distinguish the illusion from the truth. What is actually the truth? The whole transcendental world. That is truth. Because what you see? Absolute truth. Because this is not destroyed. We are not, this body is not the absolute truth. But our soul is absolute truth also. Because it's not destroyed. It's also truth. It's not the big absolute truth, Christa, but it's also absolute truth. Because my soul is always real. Everything in the spiritual world is absolute truth. Because this is not destroyed. So you see, it all depends from which angle we start seeing. For he is the absolute truth. But my soul is also the absolute truth. But. Something that not can be destroyed is absolute truth. The whole spiritual world is also absolute truth. And then you can say, yeah, but it's truth. What do you mean by the truth? God Christ is lying. He is stealing. You see, absolute truth means it's not destroyed. You see, it's from which angle we start seeing this, even the sastras, what the Lord starts seeing. You see, that's why it seems, like yesterday with Freddy, how is it possible that person, it depends from which angle that person, you know, we have to understand, we don't know where Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Holy preaching about a certain point for which angle he was looking. And Prabhupada, see the same point, but from in his preaching for where they were. And that we have also have to understanding time, place and circumstances. Because are we not absolute truth? Not this body, I mean. Because everything here will be destroyed. But my soul is absolute truth. It's a part. Let's say maybe this better. It's a part of the absolute truth. The whole spiritual world, in Vaikunthas, are also absolute truth. Because they are not destroyed. What is destroyed is not absolute truth. It is temporary. So you see, that's why sometimes it seems that in even persons seems contradiction. But is it really contradiction? Because we have And that we don't know. They are not contradiction, but you should actually, like, but I say it. If you were there, when Holy was talking, right, and then, yeah, from which angle he was seeing this? And from which angle Prabhupada is seeing this? Because River, what I felt when River was reading, what I see, absolute truth. It came out from me what she was speaking. See, absolute truth. We have the truth, but it is the absolute truth. Yeah. But for me, it came out as that he's not lying. That truth. Like going to the Bible. You swear the truth, but not with the truth. The absolute truth. For me, it was like that she was talking. I couldn't be wrong, you know, but I felt it was that. But we know he's stealing butter. He's lying. So where's then the absolute truth? So you see, even this absolute truth can create already. That's why you need a Bonavaya Charya, a Srila Gauravacharya, who can really clarify this. What is actually absolute truth? It depends, because truth, you see, that's why it's not so easy to understand all these things. Because River said, yeah, you have truth, but it's the absolute truth. But you can see it that of speaking the truth. But he's stealing. Absolute truth is it stay ever. Krishna body is never destroyed. You see, even this, from which angle we see this? Absolute truth means it's there forever. This material is temporary. That's why this may say that it's not really the truth. But if you start thinking on, the truth of it, the whole truth, Krishna Christiana, yeah, but I heard this yesterday. I was thinking of that. From which angle we have to see this? This absolute truth. You see? Because a person, for me, I could be wrong, but I had the feeling that, you see, we have the truth, but Krishna is the absolute truth. But you can think in the truth of talking the truth. That's also truth. But we have to see, that's why I'm saying, mention here absolute truth, because we have to see in the beginning. There's a solution. Voila, take it out. Stupid for me. You see, for he is the absolute truth. Because what it means, we have to go to the verse before, the text before. That's mentioned. Only because of him do the material universe temporary. You see? How we have to see it? It's about that saying. So you see, it's not always easy to understand the books. See, I'm going to read this again. Then we will get clarified. Only because of him do the material universe temporarily manifested by the reaction of the three modes of nature. That's what it means. It is temporary, not truth. Yeah, I don't know. I have some problem with internet here. Maybe I have to move. Let's see, it will be better over there. So you see, it's not always easy to get what in the heart of this. And now we have this, we have here what he really meaning. But see, he was first talking only because of him due to material world temporary manifested. You see, temporary. That's why it's not truth. It is temporary. But he, not only he, but all the spiritual world, all the devotees, everything is absolute truth. My soul is also absolute truth. Because I have nothing to do with this material world. So you see, it's not always easy to understand it. And for me, I could be wrong, but for me, when she was talking river, it was, yeah, we have the truth. But he's the absolute truth. But he's stealing. He's lying. But here it means absolute truth is not destroyed. I therefore meditate of him, Lord Sri Krishna, who is eternal existent. In the transcendental abdom, which is forever free from the illusion representation of material world. I meditate upon him, for he is the absolute truth. But see? Absolute truth. But all the spiritual world is absolute truth. That's why it's not always easy from which angle we have to approach this. Absolute truth. You see? Because if you take it like from, you see, and it is also, the sastras, it is, that's why it's not easy to understand everything. Because what is mentioned also? I'll read this also again. Yeah, I hope you can follow it. My thinking is not always easy, my thinking, I know that. But see? It is he only who first impart the Vedic knowledge unto the heart of Brahmaji, the original living entity. It's true. It's not a lie. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, yes, then there's something higher. Spontaneous analyte devotion. Spontaneous. Because what is mentioned? If you are attracted to the love of the gopis, you're not interested in the Vedic. So see, it's not always easy to understand this. That's why you need a bona fide acharya who really can clarify this. Oh yeah, you see? One moment. Also, Krishna is saying this in the beginning, I believe. One moment. 3, I believe it is 3. Manjikista, 3. Yeah. Voila. Everywhere in the world, people worship me according to the spiritual injunction. It is he only who first... Whoa. I have to say this right now. It is only who first import the Vedic knowledge onto the heart of Ramaji. Uh-huh. It's perfect. Because it is him, the Lord himself, who gives it in the heart. The Vedic injunction. Yeah? But what mentions here? Everywhere in the world, people worship me according to the spiritual injunction. But simple following such a regular principle, one cannot attain the loving sentiment of devotees of Rajabhoomi. So you see, that's why you need what? A bonafide acharya, a Srila Gaura Haridas Maharaj. Because it seems that the Lord is contradicting himself. No, this is for the beginning step. And then to get Krishna, Vrajabhoomi, that is totally different. You see? And that's why most of the spiritual masters, for them even, why? Bhagavad Gita 10.10. You see, because mentioned also here. Wait, huh? What was it again? But by him, even great saints and demigods are in illusion. So, we are also in illusion. But, you see, it's not, we have to start seeing in the whole picture more. What is the Gita said that Maharaj is using so much? Those who worshiping me in ecstatic love, I give them understanding. This is the secret to understand how everything really is. Because you can study the I try it also. Study the books reading from. Also my neighbor came. Hey, Johan, you know, for me, it's enough, you know, these books. It's full contradiction. I cannot follow anymore. I try to explain it. Hey, time, place, circumstances. We have to understand this also. I see in the beginning, Brahma get the Vedic injunction. And Krishna said, yes, but follow just the spiritual injunction. You cannot get what? The loving sentiment of the voice of Rajabhoomi. And that's why most are stuck in this. From Lord Brahma. Vedic. Wait, I have to see it, I said it right. The Vedic knowledge. You see, everybody is stuck on there. But Krishna is saying, okay, you see, Krishna is not saying it is totally wrong. No, it's necessary for the soul who come in this material world, yes, to back your connection with the Lord. So that in the beginning, we have that. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he came. But even Krishna said it. Huh? Everywhere in the world, people worship according to the spiritual injunction. So it seems, what is going on here? Because why? Bhagavad Gita also is telling us there are two paths of Bhakti Yoga. One, what our Acharya is showing, but still 90.9% of devout is, can it understand this? That there are two paths. One, you see, the first one is mentioned, is what all Acharya Srila Gaurav Maharaj is showing us. Unalloyed devotion. Because it's mentioned, a person who have unalloyed devotion to me. And the other is, if you don't have this, then you have to follow these rules and regulations to come attached to it, to want to have this. Everywhere the people worshiping me according to the spiritual injunction, but simply following the certain regular principles, so the second path, you cannot get to Tvarajibomi. And this is what I noted. When I was in the temple, none of them was talking about these two paths. Why? Because they were not on that first path. That's why they always said, yes, we have to follow the Vedic injunction. Because this is given to Brahma. But Krishna is saying, not that way you get to Vrajabhumi. And that's why I also mention, I have to say this, luckily I have my list. I have to start, well, it's now 1 or 2. I have to see, it's... No, it's not that. Oh, it's Madhya Lila chapter 8, yes. Madhya Lila chapter 8, I believe, I hope it is that. yeah, thought so. Madhya Lila chapter 8, verse 220. No, 9, 8. Voilà. One of that is dus Madhya Lila chapter 8, verse 220. One who is attracted by the one who is attracted by the ecstatic love of the gopis do not care about the popular opinion of the regular principle of the Vedic life. You see, that's why you need really all Acharya, Srila, Gaura, Hari, Das Maharaj to get through these things. Because what is mentioned also in the Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam, I believe also Srimad Bhagavatam, but also Chaitanya Amrita, it's a mystery. It's a mystery. So how can we get to, if even great sages, demigods are in illusion. Krishna gave him the Vedic injunction to Lord Brahma, first spelled the master. And then Krishna say, yeah, okay, but for the kid to me, Vrajabhumi, something total different. And that's why it means here also, one who is at... one who is attracted by ecstatic love. You see, ecstatic. It's not sahaja, ecstatic love of the gopis do not care about the popular opinion of the regular principle of Vedic life. Rather, he completely surrender unto the Krishna and render service unto him. It's not only gopis, you know, It is all Vrajaboomi. Because in Vrajaboomi, everybody is there ecstatic. So, and this is still the problem going on. Vedic injunction, Muslims stuck there. And our Acharya is showing something totally different path. The path of spontaneous. And that's why Krishna is saying, hey, you see, if you follow the spiritual injunction on the Vedas, yes, it's okay. Oh, yeah. I cannot say it's a lie. Srila Gaurahamrita is not saying it's a lie. He's saying it's not enough. Or it's not good. It means it's a total different path. And then he's coming, yeah, but you see the Vedic injunction, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, yeah. But this is something total different. So, if you cannot accept what is the Bhagavad Gita also saying, two paths of Bhakti Yoga. One, who have a regular or a charya, underlying devotion. And the other path, if you do not have it, then rules, regulation to come attached to Krishna. So when you will be really attached, and this attachment is not possible if you stick on this Vedic injunction. And that's why, you see, it seems that, because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and our acharyas, yeah, they make it much simpler. And this also we have to understand. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he came specially to show it. You see, he came as a devotee. Yes? He showed us how we, because we are also devotees. Yes? How the easy path. Percent of Godhead. Combination of Radha Krishna, yes? As a devotee, see, for us, fools, rascals, if we follow that path, what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought 550 years ago, and now what our Acharya again is showing, you see, guys, see, this is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought us. This path, as a devotee, because we are all souls are devotee. Okay, so maybe you can devote to Ram or this, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought this for the devotion to Vrajaboomi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed this path. Hey guys, see, I, as person of Godhead, I came here as a devotee because all of you are also devotees. If you follow this path, you come to Vrajaboomi. Our Acharya is doing just the same. Hey guys. Yeah, I said, okay, I will say all devotees, but I think guys mean woman, everybody, yes? He's saying, hey, see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he make it easy. Qualification or not qualification? But everybody's thinking, no, I must be qualified. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, not necessary. So you see, everybody try to do it by themselves. And Krishna is saying in the Gita, no, the only way to get out this illusion, to understand really how it is, I, as Krishna is saying, give the knowledge how we get out of this illusion. And that's why Bhagavad Gita 10:10, those who will be in ecstatic love, I gives understanding. To get out. Because it's mentioned here also. Once again. Only because of him do the material universe temporarily manifested by the reaction of the three moods of material natures. It's temporary. So if you stay in goodness, your whole being is temporary. That's why you have to take a birth again. Okay, I'm gonna stop now. Because maybe someone else would want to go live. Because I'm gonna take a shower now. So Hare Krishna, thanks for coming. Thanks for allowing me this talking. And you see me all later. Hare Krishna, thanks for coming. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.